Technological advancements with artificial intelligence, otherwise known as AI, have revolutionized every aspect of life. AI technology uses machine learning and is starting to completely change healthcare as we know it, including drug development. At MIT, or the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, researchers have recently used the deep learning model AI to identify a powerful new drug. The newly discovered drug is an antibiotic compound known as Halicin and has been found to successfully kill some of the most pathogenic and disease-causing bacteria, including many strains which are typically resistant to antibiotics. The computer model can rapidly screen millions of compounds for powerful candidates that can be developed into antibiotic drugs. This is extremely promising, especially due to the increasing prevalence of resistant strains. But before we get into that, let's understand the immune function, how bacteria work, and the need for antibiotics in the first place. The immune system refers to all of the cells and tissues that help protect the human body from pathogens and diseases. When foreign substances known as antigens are detected, the body triggers white blood cells like B lymphocytes to protect the body by creating antibodies. Antibodies are proteins that can specifically lock onto certain antigens and can cause their destruction with the help of T cells. Once an antibody is created for a certain germ or bacterium, it creates an immunity to that antigen for life, as your body always has the blueprint for making an antibody to the same antigen. Many types of bacteria are not harmful, but some can produce toxins, which are chemicals that damage our cells and thus cause diseases. For instance, strep throat, tuberculosis, and urinary tract infections are caused by harmful bacteria. This is where antibiotics come in. Antibiotics can vary in mechanism and bacterial targets, but they all work to break down essential structures or processes within the bacterial cell. This either results in death of the bacterial cell or slows down its growth to allow more time for the immune response. Before antibiotics, over 30% of all deaths in the United States were caused by bacterial infections, but with antibiotics, this number has drastically decreased. However, an unnecessary or excess dosage of antibiotics can increase the risk of bacterial resistance. Some bacterial species can spontaneously mutate under the pressure of antibiotics. It makes them resistant to the given antibiotic and allows them to survive in the microenvironment. If this occurs, it can cause detrimental effects because resistant bacteria can share their genetic material containing the mutations to other bacteria in the surrounding environment. If the surrounding bacteria receive the genetic blueprint, they also have the means of becoming resistant. To worsen the scenario, all these resistant bacteria can continue replicating even in the presence of antibiotics, and bacteria divide quite rapidly. This causes a catastrophe as the immune system's response and the antibiotics do not decrease the bacterial infection and makes the illness more and more severe in the host. With the increase of excess antibiotic usage and a decline in funding and new antibiotic discoveries, many bacterial species including Clostridioides difficile, Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and Staphylococcus aureus are becoming more and more resistant over time. This produces superbugs, bacteria immune to almost every current therapeutic. In fact, currently more than 2.8 million antibiotic-resistant infections occur each year in the United States. Each year, there are a minimum of 35,000 deaths due to bacterial resistance. And by 2050, superbugs are likely going to cause more deaths than cancer. This creates a huge need for drugs that work against antibiotic-resistant bacterium to win the battle in this evolutionary race. Well, you must be wondering that there are probably alternative therapeutics to prevent bacterial infections. Scientists are currently studying bacteriophage therapy. Bacteriophages are viruses that only kill bacteria and do not target other species including us, humans. In fact, there are so many phages, even more than bacterial species themselves. So, how does the phage work? The phage injects its genetic material inside the bacterial cell. The bacterial cell thus becomes occupied with producing the viral proteins more than their own proteins, which are essential for survival. Once enough viral proteins are replicated, phages secrete enzymes like endolysin to create holes in the bacteria, causing them to burst or explode. The newly synthesized phage material is released to infect more bacteria, repeating the cycle again and again. This therapy provides great insight as it can be injected into humans. As mentioned before, phages are very specialized towards a specific bacterium and its relatives, so humans are immune to them. This specificity can also prevent the killing of the good bacteria or probiotics in our gut. However, this specificity can also cause drawbacks. Antibiotics are normally generalized molecules targeting several bacterial species, but since the phage is specific to a certain bacteria type, the therapy cannot be generalized. Another drawback includes the method of administration, as it requires special training. Also, with these new interventions, bacteria can become resistant to the phage over time. However, phages can also acquire mutations to continue the evolutionary battle. With all this, the therapy is still under clinical trials, additional research is required, and there is no official approval from the FDA. Thus, big pharmaceutical companies are not ready to invest. Bacterial infections have been a major concern in the medical field for decades. While new innovations are being developed to prevent such infections, it might be more beneficial to improve the current methods of treatment so that we can effectively target bacteria and superbugs. What if we told you that there is a potential breakthrough in the treatment of bacterial infections using artificial intelligence? Researchers at MIT have found a potential compound using a machine learning algorithm, which they named Halicin. This antibiotic compound has killed many of the world's most problematic disease-causing bacteria, including some strains that are resistant to all known antibiotics. Fascinatingly, the same computer model which was designed to detect Halicin can be programmed to recognize other drugs with antibacterial properties. With the capacity to screen over 100 million compounds in just a few days, this new computer model enhances the efficiency of identifying potential therapeutic products at an accelerated rate. The discovery of Halicin has propelled the battle against bacterial infections into a new era. After screening over 6,000 compounds, MIT's AI technology identified Halicin as having an unprecedented chemical structure, setting it apart from traditional antibiotics. And the best part? It turns out that Halicin has low toxicity in humans. Halicin did not disappoint in its performance either. Its antibacterial powers were tested on various strains of bacteria, including the culprits behind diarrhea, colitis, meningitis, and tuberculosis. Next, the researchers took it up a notch and tested Halicin's efficacy on living animals. In just 24 hours, the application of Halicin-containing ointment on infected mice cleared a notorious antibiotic-resistant infection that often afflicts US soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan. The researchers attribute Halicin's magic to its unique ability to interfere with the bacteria's energy source, ATP, by altering the cell's electrochemical gradient. This lack of energy results in a lower mutation rate in the targeted area, making the bacteria less likely to develop resistance. The world of medicine is evolving, and scientists at MIT are at the forefront of groundbreaking research. Thanks to AI technology, researchers have discovered other potential compounds that could revolutionize the treatment of bacterial infections. In just 3 days, the AI model was able to screen 100 million molecules and discover 23 other possible bacterial drugs that show no toxicity to humans. But they are not stopping there. The researchers plan to conduct further experiments to study the effects of potential bacterial drugs on human health. Their ultimate goal is to modify existing antibiotics, making them specifically target harmful bacteria with the help of machine learning. With these exciting new discoveries, we can see the potential of artificial intelligence in the fight against bacterial infections. The potential to save countless lives is within our grasp, and researchers at MIT are leading the way. MIT's discovery of Halicin through AI is revolutionary and shows promising advancements in fighting bacterial infections. Based on its time and cost effectiveness, AI can screen and find new antibiotics. Thus, AI has proven to be a powerful tool and has already changed the world in many ways. However, there are limits to the use of artificial intelligence. For starters, AI is unable to respond to new problems using knowledge it has acquired prior. This means that AI struggles to respond to novel changes it encounters during problems. For example, if there are errors in a set of data being analyzed by AI, it will not be able to assess and adapt to these errors. Additionally, AI is only able to provide the final result of the designated task at hand. This means that scientists are unable to see the decision-making process and steps taken by the AI to come to the final conclusion. Scientists cannot recreate the work or double-check for any mistakes by AI. Furthermore, although the discovery of Halicin is promising for fighting bacterial infections, there are still limitations to this antibiotic. Research shows that the ability for the bacteria to become resistant to Halicin is low, but it is still possible to become resistant and form superbugs. Despite the use of AI, antibiotic resistance is a naturally occurring phenomenon and cannot be entirely avoided. In conclusion, the use of AI has advanced society in many ways. Specifically, the use of AI with medicine has already produced promising results. AI is being used for drug discovery, identifying diseases, discovering new treatments, and much more. Despite the setbacks of using AI, the world is rapidly changing, and artificial intelligence will allow scientists to make advancements and create better medical care in the future.